Which drive is the Kootenays' best rock? CHDR 102.9 Cranbrook, Kimberly. CJDR 99.1 Fernie Sparwood. We are a division of the Jim Pattison Broadcast Group. And now, Drive News.
6:30, I'm Jeff Johnson, and it's minus one in the Elk Valley, minus two in Cranbrook. News is for Ashbury Glass, Urban Root Salon and Spa, and Aaron's. Plenty of snow came down over the night, with more snow expected in the Elk Valley this morning. A snowfall warning remains in effect for the Elk Valley, with an additional 5 centimeters of snow expected this morning. Drivers throughout the region are reporting slick and slippery conditions, with compact snow on highways throughout the East Kootenay. If you need to drive for your Christmas plans, be sure to drive to the conditions and plan ahead. It's the busiest day of the year for Santa Claus, but he'll take some time out to visit Cranbrook today. With the assistance of Cranbrook Fire and Emergency Services, Old St. Nick will be touring through the cities beginning around 4 p.m. The tour begins in the Park Royal area, then Santa will roll by the Fire Hall and Highland School through most of the rest of the city, capping it off in the Slater Road area. You can find a complete tour schedule on our website or follow Santa's progress real-time on the Cranbrook Professional Firefighters Local 1253 Facebook page. Santa will also be touring in Kimberly later on tonight. Last Friday, Cranbrook RCMP arrested a man wanted on warrants from Dawson Creek, and he now faces even more charges. 25-year-old Travis Lozier was arrested in front of the Cranbrook Safeway. Then police found a loaded shotgun, cocaine, and money in his home near Amy Woodland Elementary. Lozier was wanted on possession for the purpose of trafficking charges in Dawson Creek and arrived in Cranbrook under an alias earlier this year. Lozier will now face numerous Cranbrook charges. He will next be in court on January 12th. And Fairmont Hot Springs will be hosting celebrations for Christmas Eve tonight. The resort will be doing their annual Christmas Eve fireworks display, with events leading up to the fireworks throughout the day. The fireworks are happening after dark, and if you can't make it out for the display tonight, you can always take in the fireworks on New Year's Eve next Thursday. Sports is for Muriel and Jane's General Store, Jackson's Heating and Air Conditioning, and Subway Restaurants. Matthew Perreault had a pair of goals, and Michael Hutchinson made 33 saves as Winnipeg toppled the Chicago Blackhawks in 5-1. Sam Gagne made life for his former club that much worse as he scored twice and set up two more in Arizona's 5-1 win over Edmonton. James Van Riemsdyk had a goal and two helpers, and Jonathan Bernier made 43 saves as the Toronto Maple Leafs halted a three-game skid by blanking the Dallas Stars 4-0, and Carey Price turned away 37 shots as the Montreal Canadiens beat the New York Islanders 3-1 for their fifth win in six games. Now checking out the World Juniors, Canada will be entering the championship with its top line in top form. Max Domi scored three times, while line mates Anthony Duclair and Sam Reinhart tacked on four assists as Canada blanked Switzerland 6-0 in its final tune-up game before opening the World Championship on Boxing Day against Slovakia. The drive weather's for Mountain Man Outdoors. Get prepared for the great outdoors with quality branding gear for hunting, fishing, camping, and hiking. Mountain Man Outdoors, your wilderness connection in downtown Cranbrook. A snowfall warning remains in effect in the Elk Valley. Today, more snowfall with about 5 centimeters expected in the Elk Valley. High of minus 1. Overnight, chance of snow continues. Low of minus 5. Thursday, Christmas Day. Mix of sun and cloud, a high of minus 1. And Friday, sunny with a high of minus 7. Right now, it's minus 1 in the Elk Valley, minus 2 in Cranbrook. I'm Jeff Johnson at 6:35.